Many years ago, I was traveling on a flight and we were carrying a set of DTs with us. And when we tried to take those DTs with us as a carry-on luggage, so there was some discussion and the people at the airlines were telling me that you cannot carry them with you because, you know, they are made out of marble and it is not proper to carry them online. When I heard that, I was trying to figure out what's the problem, and I tried to tell them that these are DTs and these are worshipable and we are taking them for actually keeping them in somebody's house so that they could worship in another part of the world. And then there was a whole discussion where some other authority came and said that, you know, why don't you try this other airlines? They always allow DTs to be carried because they understand and appreciate what actually worshipping a DT at a home actually means. And then so this discussion sparked off a lot of interest in those who were behind the counter and issuing the boarding pass. And then finally, they actually escorted these DTs and actually gave them a nice place in the first class cabin and transported them very safely so that these DTs could be actually installed in someone's homes for their worship. And this actually made me thinking that what exactly makes a home into a temple? Temple is a place where three things happen. First, there is spiritual knowledge which is discussed. Second, there is knowledge transmission. And third, there is a heart transformation. So wherever there is knowledge, wherever there is discussion, and wherever there is transformation, that's a place which is actually a temple. And therefore, when members of a house come together and they decide that we are going to utilize this house, the precincts of this house, as a means to transform our consciousness, at that very moment, that house becomes a temple. Why? Because you have started accepting that whoever is providing for me becomes very important for me in my life. If a small boy is given a glass of water, his immediate response will be, "Thank you." Just imagine that we are getting so much from the Supreme. We are getting food, we are getting air, we are getting water. But in reciprocation, when we are living in our home, are we able to acknowledge that whatever I am receiving is thanks to the divine grace? So when we begin acknowledging that, that's the beginning of actually converting our home into a temple. And then members of the family come together and they actually hear and discuss various stories, various pastimes from the various ancient literatures, and that actually creates inspiration within each and every member of the family. It creates a bonding amongst all the members of the family because we are now centered around something transcendental with a spirit of gratitude and thankfulness. And therefore, it's possible for each and every person to actually create a temple within his home when he acknowledges that beyond me, there is someone else who's the proprietor of the entire creation, someone else who's the proprietor of all the wealth, proprietor of this house, and I am simply a trustee who has been given an opportunity to take care of these resources on his behalf. My family members are also part of that entire scheme when I am simply a trustee in making sure that the best possible facilities and the best possible care is provided using me as an instrument. Dear friends, it's not difficult to actually experience temple in one's home. It is a matter of transforming and adjusting our consciousness in acknowledging who is the center of the house here, me or the Supreme, who's actually the cause of everything.